Okay, hello there. It is Monday, October 10th, 2016. And hi, my name is Wanda Fay, Wanda Fay Gladwell. And I'm just coming to you from Southern Sunny California. Really, this message is for Speaker Ryan. Speaker Ryan, I just really don't get it, okay? I know that you're trying to portray a very holy man up there in Congress, apparently. I don't know what kind of message you're trying to send to whosoever, but you really are, in my opinion, really, really, really blowing it, okay? You know, just think about what you're doing and think about the influence that you are having over people, okay, and this election. Now, nobody's asking you to endorse Donald Trump, and I just watched Shepard Smith on Fox News, and he just pointed out that you never did endorse real Donald Trump. So, when you didn't endorse him yesterday or whenever was it unlawful back then 10, 11 years ago to record somebody without their consent? I don't know. You guys make the rules up there. You guys make the laws up there in Congress. Okay, so I'm just blabbing, okay? I apologize. I don't know how to speak very well. I had problems my entire life with that. I failed. Well, I didn't fail college. I went to college for 8 full-time years. And yes, I am a college-educated woman for Trump. But what really held me back was my own self and my own fears of speaking in front of people. So, because I had to take you have to take the speech class in order to take the education classes. And my dad wanted me to be a teacher. So back then I wasn't thinking too well for myself and just thought I'd honor my father and try to be a teacher. So I ended up, and he didn't even know that I didn't continue with those education classes because of fear of speaking and taking the speech class. So I'm just trying to learn here myself and trying to do the best I can. But I'm really astonished at you. What's the message that you're sending out there at this last day, at the end here of right before the election? It just really, I could really cry over this, okay? But you know what? I have to believe in our God. I have to believe, first of all, faith in God and that God can help Mr. Trump win this election without you, without really anybody, okay? God can help him win, but this is our United States of America. God gave us our government. God gave us the way it is. He made the elections, okay? And yes, it's rigged, and yes, it's not fair. But God, if God wants him in there, he can put him in there with or without you, with or without your endorsement, or without your, you know, going to bat for him. It's just really, I'm just actually astonished, though, because, you know, liberals have been in charge of our country for a long time, okay? And let me give you a little history. Back about 43 years ago, abortion was legalized in America. And around that time, I had an abortion and I wasn't a Christian. And for some reason, it was out there and it was legal. So in my stupidity, in my lack of wisdom, lack of caring about what was inside my body, growing inside my body after, you know, messing around. I had an abortion because I was fearful of my father. I was terrified that he would disown me. Well, you know, So it was available to me back then, but I really highly doubt that if it wasn't available. This is not about the abortion. Maybe it is. This is not about Mr. Trump getting in there to be president to reverse Roe versus Wade. But look at what we have. Look at the alternative. And I don't really look at this election that, well, we have two, look what we have for two choices. No, I really support Mr. Donald Trump from the very beginning. I highly respect him. I believe that he is a good man. You know, and what he did 11 years ago, hey, you know, are you going to base this entire country and the outcome of this election on what he did 11 years ago? You keep wavering over your support for him. You know, you're disgusting, okay? You make me sick, okay? You are a self-righteous, whitewashed, prideful, arrogant person. And I'm assuming that you're a Christian, okay? Okay, so anyway, I had my abortion in college, and I went through life, and, you know, the day that I had my abortion, I came back, and I threw a bowl of oatmeal at the wall, because something inside of me was raging, and that was the guilt and the grief that I had just murdered my own little baby, okay? And that's what that oatmeal thrown at the wall was. I wasn't like that. I wasn't, you know, but something inside of me was just, you know, raging because of what I just did. I had no idea what I just did. I just knew that I had to get rid of what was inside of me so that my father wouldn't disown me. Okay, so what I'm saying is think about the implications that you are having on voters. Okay. Hillary is going to follow. We already know what Hillary wants, okay? Let me go back to several years after I had my abortion, it began to affect me, okay, in a great and mighty, horrible way. It shook my life, okay? The guilt that I had and the grief that I had. Thank God he allowed me to have another little baby, wonderful little baby boy, and he's 32 years old, and he's the most amazing, wonderful child, okay? I don't know what kind of thing you're trying to pull with trying to impress your family, your wife, your children, whatever, your constituents. But we don't have to have you prove that you are righteous by throwing Donald Trump under the bus. We don't need you to do that. We're already smart enough, okay, to know that you probably didn't do stuff like that or say stuff like Mr. Trump said 11 years ago. However, I thank God that in 1977, when I was 26 years old, I went down and I walked down the church aisle and accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, and he forgave me for all of my sins, including that abortion. What really troubles me is that people like you, people like Jason in the House, Chafis, you self-righteous Republicans, conservatives, so-called conservatives. I don't even want to use, you know, I've been studying politics for 8 years, and I didn't know that I was a Republican conservative. I voted liberal when I liked a candidate that was liberal, or, you know, I voted for Bush when I liked Bush. I'm just saying I wavered this and I wavered that, and you are really a bad example for all of us, all Americans. You are such a bad example, you people, you never Trump people. I'm telling you what, I'm going to stick with Mr. Trump, and I'm going to hope and pray to God Almighty pray for his safety, his health. Oftentimes I'll start to call him Pastor Trump because I believe he loves the people more than you could ever love the people of God and of America and of this world. So you go ahead and just keep it up. Stick with what your conscience. Vote your conscience. Yeah, okay. And, you know, God bless America.